Diesel. Warning. Oh, it's too early, man. Get that thing out of here.
Yeah, it's actually not that early at all. It's almost noon. Oh, but we, like I said, we drove super late yesterday. By the time I was showered and in bed, it was about 3 in the morning. And now we got to drive down. We got 2 days to drive, 1 day pretty much. But we need to reset once we get down there. Like, I need to sit for a day so that I can drive more. It's just part of the rules. But we're going to get going now. And I'll talk to you in a little bit. No messing around. Let's get back on the road.
Are you guys ready to rock? Ready to rock and roll? Here we go, Diesel. Oh, I did my walk around my vehicle, made sure everything was gonna stay attached to the vehicle, made sure the tires weren't gonna fall off. We're good to go. So like I was saying, we're in Sioux Falls, South Dakota at the Flying J here. Got another full day of driving ahead of us. Not sure where we're gonna make it quite yet. We'll figure that out later on our break. Once we know the traffic situation a little bit better. Merging onto Interstate 29 South Dakota. Meandering our way down there for a while. I guess the next city we're going to be going through will be Sioux City. A lot of Sioux stuff around here. Sioux Falls, Sioux City. This interstate, if I were to go the opposite direction,
6 kilometers on I-29 south.
Up north, this freeway would lead directly right into Winnipeg, Manitoba. This actually, if you stay on this road, it will take you right downtown Winnipeg. It's the exact same road. It turns into Pembina Highway, and then that takes you right downtown Winnipeg. That's about a day's drive behind me. We're going away from home. Because I hear that there's snow around there already. Figured, I told you. Got pictures from Edmonton and reports from New Brunswick that there is snow going on today. So we're gonna go south. We're gonna follow the geese. We're gonna go down here and hang out here for a while.
Food. Need food. That's the sign I saw from the interstate. They didn't say what kind of food, but they just said food. And my stomach went, I would like some, please.
Diesel, what do you think? You hungry too? You got food back there, man?
Yeah, you got food back there. So I'm going to make a point of trying to exercise more, trying to eat on a regular schedule, trying to get more vegetables and fruits into my diet, stuff like that. And I'd like to be able to go for a run every day. We're starting off with our speed walking right now, but I think very soon in the next couple of days, if not today, I want to start taking the time every day to just go for a 10-minute run. 10 minutes of solid running. Stuff like that or something. I was going to take my running shoes with me on this trip, but I forgot them at home. But we've got to make more of a point of being healthy. Our bodies are a gift. We're not supposed to put garbage into them because then we will become garbage. You are what you eat. It's very true. And if you want to live a long life, you got to eat right. Now, right now, my age and people when I was younger, even you're thinking, well, whatever. I'll eat whatever I want. I'll get healthy when I get older. I'll eat healthier when I start having problems. Well, when you start developing problems, it's already too late. It's already too late. I mean, the average lifespan of a truck driver is what, between 60 to 70 years? And if you want to get into your 80s, you got to get your butt in gear and start doing something. Think of it as an engine idling. For you drivers out there, or you guys who know diesel engines, you know what happens when you sit there with your truck idling at low idle overnight or something. In the morning, it's got a whole bunch of soot and stuff to burn out. I mean, if you drive a DEF truck, you probably don't know this if you've never driven a regular truck. But a truck like mine, if you idle it over the night, for the first couple of minutes after you start going, it might smoke some white smoke out. Mine doesn't do that, but some trucks do that. It's burning all the soot out from idling, because a diesel engine is designed to pull and to have, you know, constant weight behind it. That's what it's designed for. Same thing with our hearts. Our hearts are designed to pump blood. It's a muscle. If you let that muscle idle for too long, it gets weak. It's like any muscle, your arm muscles. If you don't exercise your arms, your arms are gonna shrink down to flub, sort of like mine. If you don't do sit-ups and exercise your abs or run, your body turns to flub, sort of like mine, right? Same thing with your heart, except it's hard to remember your heart because you can't see it. It's hidden in there. If you don't exercise it, it's gonna get weak, and one day when you need it, it's not gonna be strong enough. And then it's called a heart attack and stuff like that. And you know, those things aren't good. You try to avoid those things. I've been talking for a while here. Let's speed walk over to Subway and get our heart pumping just a little bit at least. Speed walking, speed walking, speed walking, speed walking. Subway, 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 Subway. That was good. I ended up jogging instead on the way back. I'm going to have to do that more often. Man, if I do that every day, by the end of winter, by next summer, I will be leaping and bounding over cars and buildings and trucks to get to wherever I need to get. I'll be like one of them jumper guys that you see out in Europe all the time. What do they call them again? They like run around and climb up walls and do backflips and stuff. Look out. Here comes Trucker Josh. I'm gonna do that more often. Wasn't even that far. That's kind of pathetic. Anyways, note to self, next time I go for a run, wear a belt. Probably looked like one of those teenagers running across the parking lot, pulling up his pants as he's running.
Far yet. We've only been driving driving about 2.5 hours, 3 hours maybe. So we got a long way to go yet. There was a car that was holding me in this left lane. Finally, he exited off. I still don't understand why some people would rather drive right beside me after I let them in. You know, you move over to let them onto the freeway and then they just sit there beside you. It's beyond me. I don't understand it. That is life. This looks like a pretty big city here. I know they got a Flying J on the west, or the, yeah, the west side of town. I used to stay there a lot when I would run from Winnipeg down to Houston, Texas all the time. I loved that run. Straight, flat run, straight south. But all I remember is going through Dallas. Oh, if you don't have a GPS or if you don't know where you're going through downtown there on the interstate, oh, you get lost.
More flags. We just entered Missouri, and I believe that that would be the Missouri flag. Interesting. Prisoners of war, missing in action, and the United States of America. Oh, I spat on my screen when I said that. Oh, man. Sitting here behind the camera looking at the screens that I knew what I was pointing at, right? And anyways.
Diesel, how you doing, buddy? You have, that sniffer is very nice, man. Thank you, man. I grew it myself. You should look a little bit more excited. You should be proud of this thing, man. I couldn't grow a sniffer like that. Look at those teeth. I like it when you touch his, when you touch him right here, he snarls. Now he's happy Diesel, happy Diesel. Now he's angry Diesel. Happy Diesel. Now he's angry Diesel. Happy. Oh. He's like, oh. Dude, you got some serious mood swings. Well, stop touching my face, man.
I don't know if you just gotta barely touch his, just touch his nose just right there, his lips, and he goes, he's not actually angry. I think it just triggers, his muscles tense up. Like,
right, Diesel? Can I do it again? I don't have to touch him. What are you doing, man? I don't want to show all my teeth.
You got nice teeth, man. Not bad. It could be a little whiter. You got to remember to brush them. Not bad. They could be a lot worse. Could be a lot worse, man.
Very nice rest areas they got down here. Look at the green grass around here. What in the world? Green grass, they still have leaves on their trees.
Hashtag jealous. Let's go learn a little bit about this area here. There's all kinds of stuff around here to learn from. What's this? I know it's a bit windy, guys. Sorry.
Energy and conservation, alternative energies. I don't want to read all that. You guys can pause it and read it if you want. I'm not reading all that. Rockport Welcome Center. So that's the state of Missouri. And the little star is where we're at. Right at the top. Interesting.
Here's some stuff over here we should go see.
Seems like this area of the state is very much into energy conservation and alternative energy, past and present. Okay, here's some more stuff you can pause and read if you want. I'll go through this. If not, I won't stay too long on it right now. There you go. I might read through this while I'm editing. I don't have time to read this right now. Nuclear power. I think I've driven past that plant before. Makes me nervous driving past a nuclear plant, man. It's like walking past a nuclear bomb in my mind. I know it's safe. Sometimes. Most times. I don't know. I don't know much about it. What's this? Biomass and biofuel. I don't like biofuel because it messes up your filters and stuff. I don't like that stuff. Biomass, anything opposed to organic. See, they put like plants and stuff into the fuel. And then it gums up your stuff. It gums up your bunk heater too. My bunk heater is gummed up again. I don't know why. We just put a new burner in there and a new fan. And it blows air, but it doesn't heat. So it's blowing air. And out the exhaust, it's just pouring out white smoke. Like if I would leave it on, people would come running up to my truck and think that it's on fire because it's just pouring out white smoke, right? Smells kind of good though. Smells like that two-stroke smell. I love that smell. Anyways. Fossil fuels. observation. Okay, coal. Some interesting facts. About where I am right now.
Yeah. If you guys want to read that, you can go back and pause the video and read through that. If you don't care, well, I'm not going to show them again. Let's go inside. Wow. Wow.
Little information center there. Oh, look at this. They got like a highway reporting thing there. See how the highway's doing? I like how this says rock. And the other side says port. Here's some interesting facts for you. History of Rockport area. Interesting. Once again, you guys can just pause it if you want to read it. Is there more? Oh, this is just a map. So we're up here, and we're gonna be going that way.
Well, off we go. Never sit still for very long, always moving. I'm kind of a history nut, though.
Drive 153 kilometers.
I don't like it when she interrupts me like that. I'm kind of a history nut, though. I like learning about the areas that I'm traveling through. So these rest areas are pretty cool. They always have all kinds of unique facts and history and stuff of the area that you're in. Very interesting. It's like history class every time you stop to go to the bathroom. Anyways. Off we go. Impatient weasel here with his fancy little light-up leash. Very fancy. We're here at the Flying J Travel Plaza. We made it to, where are we, Diesel? You remember where we are? Russellville, Arkansas. Russellville. This is what it looks like in Russellville at night. Look at all these trucks here. Eh? Look at all that. Isn't that beautiful? Apparently my lens is a bit dirty. I haven't used this camera in a while. This is my handy cam. It works best at night. Is it? I don't know. It's the most expensive camera I own, so it better do best at night, you know what I mean? I only use it at night. Oh man, Diesel, are you ever pulling? He must really have to go. So it's been a good day. It's been a long day. We drove pretty much the full 11 hours we were allowed to drive. Like, isn't that just the most beautiful sight you could ask for? What do you think, man? I said, I like the way you're glowing with that leash.
Well, you all know what to do down below in the description. There should be some links there. Give them a click if you feel like it. If you don't feel like it, that's totally cool also. I'll be back on this channel again, like every other day, tomorrow, 4 a.m. Central Time. We're not gonna be going anywhere tomorrow. We're gonna be pretty much figuring out what to do from here. Maybe we can go for a walk somewhere. We're sort of in a town area here. But we'll see. Figure out something, right? We always do.